Love is truly a beautiful feeling. It's one of resonance, of being in harmony with the thing that is loved. So that can either be a person or it can actually be a dream, a goal that you have. Since we all have goals and also the desire most of the time to actually have a partner, both of these cases demand of us that we learn to love, to truly love. And that's exactly what we're going to get into through this video. Welcome back to this new inspirational video. Today I wanted to go over a quote said by Emmett Fox, and he shared with us the following. There's no difficulty that enough love will not conquer, no disease that love will not heal, no door that enough love will not open. It makes no difference how deep is set the trouble, how hopeless the outlook, how muddled the tangle, how great the mistake. A sufficient realization of love will dissolve it all. If only you could love enough, you would be the happiest and most powerful being in the world. Now that's a very powerful statement to make. He actually aimed it at a couple of situations that we all might face throughout our lifetime in general, but we want to specifically understand, how do we use love in order to actually realize dreams and goals that we have in life? How do you do that? Well, as I said in the intro, love is a state of resonance, of being in harmony. So in reality, if you love your own dream, which is very powerful, even though it might seem a little absurd, you place yourself mentally and emotionally in such harmony with the dream that you desire to realize that it becomes impossible not to realize it. Now really think about that, because what happens most of the time? Well, most of the time what happens with people is that they have the dream, they start doubting. If you are with a person that you truly love, you don't want to doubt in them. You don't feel the need to doubt in them, to question them, to distrust them. You're just in harmony with them. You just accept them the way they are. Now do that with your own goals and dreams in life. Your dreams are inspiring you to become a bigger, better version of yourself. Are you accepting of that? Are you accepting that premise that you would become a bigger, better version of who you really are? If you can do that through the act of love, then it becomes so much easier to actually grow in that direction and make stuff happen. I think that is what Emmett Fox meant, especially at the end of his quote, where he said that if only you could love enough, you would be the happiest and most powerful being in the world. Is that really true? Well, it is true, because most people, they suffer from so many conflicts inside their consciousness that they cannot make stuff happen at all. And if they do, it happens very sporadically and with a lot of effort and frustration and failure and setbacks and disappointments, all that stuff. But you see, if you could love your own dream in this case, you will no longer let those things hold you back or set you back. Maybe bad times happen, but because of the love that you feel inside of you, you're able to keep growing in that direction. You're willing to grow. You're willing to expand. You're willing to accept the setbacks for what they are. Temporary failures, perhaps. Temporary setbacks. Temporary obstacles. You realize it's all temporary because the power of love that exists within me can overcome it all. It inspires me to look beyond that obstacle. It inspires me to look beyond everything that I think is wrong about the situation so that I can see the best in the situation instead. And state of love causes you to be able to perceive in others the good in them instead of fault finding, instead of always thinking, well, you're doing this wrong, that is wrong about you, you're making a mistake here and there. And you see, this ties into the whole attitude that we are treating ourselves in that way more often than not. It's very sad. Most people actually are very critical of themselves. Even I have to be careful that I'm not too critical of myself. Having a little criticism about your own behavior is healthy, because if you are being stupid, it's nice to know and to have a conscience to know when you're doing it. But other than that, you don't want to beat yourself up too much. You don't want to make it in a way that you start to feel bad about yourself in its entirety, and therefore you're unable to actually act on your own dreams or goals in life. If you want a wonderful relationship, for example, being in that state of love, of actual powerful unconditional love, you'll be able to perceive in your potential partner, if you don't have one yet, but even if you do have one, you'll be able to see the good in them, and that makes you so much more attractive in general. But if you don't have a partner, but you walk around in a state of pure love, you'll be so more attractive than somebody that is constantly thinking, why am I single? Why does nobody want to date me? I'm such a lovable person. I'm a very kind person. I've heard this before. People would tell me in private their stories where they would say, I'm such a kind person, but for some reason, nothing works out for me. And that attitude, I would have to say, is not the best to have, where you're like, I'm such a kind person, but if it doesn't show up in your actions, it doesn't matter if you say that you're a kind person. This feeling of love has to take you over so that you truly become a kind person, and you don't even have to say it out loud. You don't have to verbally express that to someone, being like, I'm a kind person, please date me. It's like you'll let it shine through your eyes and through your soul, through who you are, and they'll pick it up. That is why love is such an important aspect to this human existence. It's one of the most important ones, in fact, because without love, even if you have dreams, again, love is resonance and harmony, you'll be out of harmony most of the time with what you desire. If you can embrace your dream as if it was a person, as if it was someone that you dearly love, as if it was a child of your soul, a spiritual child that you want to nurture, that you want to give life, that you want to help expand in life and become the biggest version of themselves, well, then you see the symbolism of what I'm getting at. This is something I wrote about years ago in a book, was that I think if you start looking at dreams as if they are the children of your soul, it becomes much more meaningful to actually act on your dream as well. Because if you physically had a child, obviously you want the best for them. You don't want the child to suffer. You want it to grow up healthy and strong and to be happy and to shine in the world. Now, think about it. If you do that for your dreams, if you act like that concerning your own dreams in life, you'll be willing to do much more than you may have done up until this point for that particular dream. And again, these are all mental games that we play in a way, but this is very important, because consciousness is the only reality. That is the main point that you want to understand. If your consciousness is not operating in the right way, everything else is going to be off track. I know this from personal experience. I'm sure you do. If you analyze yourself just a little bit, you'll understand this is the truth. The better I feel, the faster I can grow towards what I want. The worse I feel, the harder it is to actually expand in the direction of what I desire. Therefore, the feeling of love is indeed one of the best feelings you could ever be in, could ever operate from. Are you feeling that warmth? That warmth, compassionate feeling of joy and compassion. You know, you want the best for others and yourself. But first of all, you want to start with yourself. Do you want the best for yourself? In order to want the best for myself, I have to love myself genuinely and not in a superficial, weird, obnoxious way, but truly want the best for yourself. Again, people don't want the best for themselves usually because of past traumas, because of how they were raised. They have these ideas in their minds that they don't deserve the best. Maybe their father or mother told them that they didn't deserve anything. Sadly, it happens to a certain percentage of people where parents can be very abusive. But again, the only way to overcome our childhood traumas is through the power of love. We have to let go of what traumatized us and start to embrace a life from a totally different angle. We have to understand that we ourselves, inside our minds, hold the power to make stuff happen. So no matter what happened to me, if I embrace the power of love, the frequency of love inside my consciousness, then I can overcome everything that has ever hurt me in my past. And that's very important to understand. That's why Neville Goddard would talk about it as well, that love is the greatest power in the universe, the most important one. And that's why Emmett Fox is talking about it as well. So if I look at the quote again, I'll repeat it. There's no difficulty that enough love will not conquer. You see, the difficulty you might have is in achieving your dream. But again, if you start loving your dream intensely enough, then you'll be able to make it happen. That's what I want you to understand. And I want you to really experiment with it for yourself. That's how you see the real power behind it. Now, no disease that love will not heal. That's true as well. Even though I can't confirm it from personal experience, I haven't been particularly ill throughout my lifetime so far, but I have heard stories, and perhaps you are one of those people that can either confirm it or not from personal experience, where feeling love, truly starting to work with the energy of love, it heals the cells in the body as well. These are real facts, but again, at first we might be skeptical about it, and therefore we don't try it, and therefore we don't see any results. But we just want to experiment with it, because why not? You don't have anything to lose by doing so. No door that enough love will not open. Well, what doors are we talking about? Well, could be all sorts of doors. I mean, it could be a door of a friend that you are having a fight with, but if you approach them from true compassion and love, they might be able to forgive you way faster than otherwise. But it can also be the door towards inspiration, to how you can realize your dreams. If you love your dream enough, the universe will open the door, the floodgates of ideas towards your consciousness, through which you will realize way more than you maybe ever thought was possible up until that point. Now, it makes no difference how deep set the trouble, how hopeless the outlook, how muddled the tangle, how great the mistake. Yes, we all make mistakes, but if we act from a place of love, we'll learn to forgive ourselves and everybody else. That's important. Forgiveness should be done from a place of love, and not just because you feel like you have to. You're forcing yourself to forgive yourself or somebody else, again, very superficially. But if you do it from a place of true universal love, then you understand that we're all one, because love will show you that we're all one. Love is that frequency of harmony. If you're in love with all of creation, you're automatically in harmony with all of creation, even though it might seem bad at first glance. When you look at a situation, it looks bad, but you still know the unity we share, the oneness behind all of the conflict. That is what love allows you to perceive. That's the important part. A sufficient realization of love will dissolve all of it. If only you would love enough, you will be the happiest and most powerful being in the world. So my question to you for this video is, are you a person that is working on this wonderful energy of love? Or are you a person that is frustrated most of the time? It doesn't really matter which side you're on, we just want to keep working with it consciously. So if you're already a person filled with love, then keep magnifying that love, keep working with it. Don't let the darkness of this world tear you away from that frequency of pure divine love. If you're a person that's always frustrated, then ask yourself, could I start loving myself a little bit more? Could I start loving this world a little bit more? Knowing that as I do so, I'm opening up my mind to the frequency of the greatest energy there is in the universe. I'm allowing myself to attract the greatest ideas that exist in the galaxy, because love is the greatest power in all of creation. And if we truly work with it, then we'll see some amazing shifts happen, both in our mental, physical, emotional well-being, but also in our physical worlds. And I think, again, that's what Emmett Fox also tried to convey to his audience back in the day. Now, if you're new to this channel, consider subscribing to receive more inspirational videos on a regular basis. And with that being said, dear viewer, never forget that we are the dreamers.